In today's top cannabis news, sneakerheads can look forward to some sweet hemp kicks from Nike. Some research on the research reveals what could be interpreted as bias in funding grants. And is the subject of a federal Colorado lawsuit a big oopsie or a big cover-up? It's Monday, August 31st, and this is your Trichomes Morning Buzz.
Broadcasting live from the Trichomes.com studios in Southern California, it's time for your Morning Buzz. We bring you late-breaking news that keeps you up to date with what's happening in the cannabis industry.
First up today, a UK retailer teamed up with Nike to launch a hemp sneaker. A UK retailer has launched a limited edition hemp textile sneaker by US athletic apparel giant Nike. Nike has partnered with the UK's size retail outlet to sell the Nike Air Zoom type hemp shoe. The shoe launched on the retailer's app and in stores on Friday, priced at £140 or $185 US. According to a Hypebeast report, Nike has also partnered with clothing brand Stüssy to manufacture another hemp-based version of its Air Force One shoe. The Fossil Stone, which features a tan upper fully constructed from rough-hewn hemp, will reportedly launch this holiday season, according to a post from sneaker leak account Pyrates, which for those of you who don't know about sneaker leak accounts is PY underscore rates.
Next, a research database shows how the U.S. funding focuses on harms of cannabis and not the medicinal benefits. According to Science Magazine, a new analysis of cannabis research funding in the United States, Canada, and the United Kingdom has found that $1.56 billion was directed to the topic between the year 2000 and 2018, with about half of the money spent on understanding the potential harms of the recreational drug. Just over $1 billion came from the biggest funder, the U.S. National Institute on Drug Abuse, which doled out far more money to research cannabis misuse and its negative effects than on using cannabis and cannabis-derived chemicals as a therapeutic drug. The government's budget is a political statement about what we value as a society, says Daniel Malinson, a cannabis policy researcher at Pennsylvania State University, Harrisburg, who reviewed the funding analysis provided to Science by the consultant who conducted it. The fact that most of the cannabis money is going to drug abuse and probably to cannabis use disorder versus medical purposes, that says something. The data confirms word on the street that government grants go to research that focus on harms, says Daniela Vergara, who researches cannabis genomics at the University of Colorado Boulder. However, overall cannabis research funding in the United States is rising steadily from less than $30.2 million in 2000 to more than $143 million in 2018, and money to explore cannabis medical treatments is growing, although not as fast as funding for research on harms.
And last up today, a multi-million dollar error at a hemp processor causes a major lawsuit. Hemp Industry Daily reports two Colorado hemp producers are suing a California processor for allegedly trying to get out of paying for hemp biomass by putting it through a spice grinder. The hemp growers, Moose Agricultural and Colorado Hemp Solutions, both of Grand Junction, Colorado, say that Lane USA and its affiliate Hemprise agreed to buy hemp biomass grown on roughly 600 acres in 2019 and 2020. Lane was to pay for the biomass based on its CBD content, if the product had at least 8% CBD, according to the growers. The biomass tested at an average of just 7.3% CBD after the biomass was run through a conventional spice grinder, which the growers say ruined the product. The grind process destroyed the samples for any meaningful testing, the growers said in a lawsuit now pending in federal court in Colorado. Moose Agricultural and Colorado Hemp Solutions are seeking $1.2 million, which they say was the amount owed under the agreement. Lane has countersued, accusing the growers of fraud and trying to pass off hot hemp, or hemp that contains higher than the legal limit of THC. The company argues that it did not violate the biomass agreement. A court date in the dispute has not been set.
And that was today's Buzz. Thanks for listening. For more cannabis news and insights from industry professionals and a place to discuss these stories and others, visit trichomes.com.
And if you love our content and want more of it on demand, you can now ask your Alexa device to enable Trichomes Radio and stream episodes of this show and our other podcasts whenever you like. For trichomes.com, I'm Allison Ben-Yehuda.
And I'm David Fortin. Enjoy the rest of your week.